Hello students, welcome back. So, we are done exploring handicraft in the previous quarter. Now are you ready for the new topic? I guess you are. Are you happy if your house is messy? Would it be comfortable to live in these surroundings? I bet you feel disgusted with this kind of environment. If your house is like this, it's time to clean. Brace yourselves as we explore cleaning tools. This is Miss Anisita B. Montesilio, your mentor. In this lesson, you will be able to identify cleaning tools, materials, and equipment, demonstrate cleaning using cleaning tools or equipment, and appreciate the importance of cleaning tools or materials in doing household cleaning chores. Students, get ready, because you're about to know the different cleaning tools, materials, and equipment and its purposes. Wow. First off, sponge. A sponge is a tool or cleaning aid made of soft, porous material, typically used for cleaning impervious surfaces. Sponges are especially good at absorbing water and water-based solutions. A towel is a piece of absorbent fabric or paper used for drying or wiping a body or a surface. It draws moisture through direct contact. Cloth is good for cleaning glass in general. Other factors come into play when cleaning electronics. It's helpful to have a cloth that can remove the dust, dirt, and smudges from the entire body of the device. A multi-purpose bucket is one of the most important cleaning tools in the household. It facilitates the cleaning enormously because you always have the cleaning water directly at your side. Spray bottle is a bottle that can squirt, spray, or mist fluids. A common use for spray bottles is dispensing cool cleaners, cosmetics, and chemical specialties. Scrub brush, also called scrubbing brush, is a brush with hard bristles for heavy cleaning. Broom is a bundle of firm, stiff twigs or fibers bound together on a long handle, especially for sweeping. It is commonly used in combination with a dustpan. Dustpan is a shovel-shaped pan used for sweepings. A mop, such as a floor mop, is a mass or bundle of coarse strings or yarn, or a piece of cloth, sponge, or other absorbent material attached to a pole or stick. It is used to soak up liquid for cleaning floors and other surfaces, to mop up dust, or for other cleaning purposes. A vacuum cleaner, also known simply as a vacuum or a hoover, is a device that causes suction in order to remove debris from floors, upholstery, draperies, and other surfaces. It is generally electrically driven. Students, those are the basic cleaning tools and equipment. Now here are some video clips on how to clean other parts in your house. Just stay tuned, because I'm going to announce your performance task later.
Years ago, we made a video called How to Clean Your Toilet in 3 Minutes, and that video has over 5 million views at the time of this shooting. And that's amazing. And it tells me that a lot of people don't know how to clean their toilet properly. And that's fine, because I didn't know how to clean a toilet properly until I started Clean My Space. And then I had to clean a lot of toilets. And I saw a lot of toilety things that perhaps I can't ever unsee and I never really wanted to see in the first place. But that aside, we're gonna plunge down today and get into the details on how to clean a toilet, because I've seen so many things and I've faced many toilet-related challenges. I know how to deal with them and I wanna pass it on to you. So we're really gonna go into the details in this video. Any toilet challenge that you're gonna face when it comes to cleaning, I'm gonna help you get over today. All right, put on your gloves, get your toilet bowl brush, and let's get to it. And just a quick reminder, if you haven't done so already, to subscribe to the Clean My Space channel and give this video a thumbs up if cleaning the toilet is your least favorite cleaning task. First things first, you always gotta put the gloves on when you're cleaning the toilet, for no other reason aside from the fact that you probably don't wanna go barehanded on this, and when you're wearing gloves, you feel a lot more brave. Now I've just got a disinfecting all-purpose cleaner and I'm spraying the toilet, all parts of it from the top, working my way down to the bottom. I'm getting things like the flusher and the little nooks and crannies, the toilet seat, and even the base at the bottom. You gotta get all of it. And then you have to let this cleaner sit for about 5 minutes so that the product can actually do the disinfecting work. If you ever notice that pink or orange bacteria building up in your toilet, it doesn't mean that you're doing anything wrong. That bacteria is just present in your bathroom. Actually, there's nothing you can do aside from clean your toilet or anything else in your bathroom on a regular basis. Now before I put the toilet bowl cleaner in, I'm going to use a plunger, and the reason I do this is to force excess water down the chute. That exposes more of the bowl, and it will allow me to get better cleaning action when I use the toilet bowl brush. You can see it significantly lowered the water level here. That is a pro tip, you guys. Now I'm applying toilet bowl cleaner starting from underneath the rim. The reason that's important is because there are tiny little water jets underneath the rim that you can't see. Now I'm spraying enzyme cleaner around the floor and the walls of the toilet. Now I'm taking paper towel, and I don't use microfiber cloths for this, and I'm just repeating my spray pattern. That way I'm always working from top to bottom and I don't miss anything. Now for these little nooks and crannies, paper towel sometimes won't cut it. So I have to bring out the big guns. And in the cleaning world, that's a cleaning toothbrush. So I'll just reapply some cleaner to a nook or a cranny or a nook and a cranny, and I just start scrubbing with the toothbrush. And what that does is it loosens up the gunk. Then I can use my paper towel and give it a good wipe. Now you don't have to do this every time, but you know, if you're having guests come over, it is not a bad thing to do. It's a lovely way to show your toilet some love. And then I take a paper towel and I essentially wedge it right into the areas that I cleaned so that I can get it nice and dirt free. Then I just continue on with a fresh paper towel. I probably go through 4 or 5 half sheets when I'm cleaning a toilet. And I always like to just fold up the paper towel and use a different section for different areas until the cloth becomes ragged and I have to toss it and grab a new piece. And I just continue top of lid, under side of lid, the top of the seat, underneath the seat, and even the top of the bowl. Now I'm cleaning the base of the toilet because, you know, a lot of us don't think about the base of the toilet, but trust me, it takes a beating. It needs some extra attention. And I'm using the cleaning toothbrush to clean the area where the toilet meets the floor, because you better believe there's some stuff built up around there as well. And guys, don't even joke about ever using that toothbrush anywhere else. Just keep it in your bathroom so you never make a mistake, but not on the counter, under the sink, or in your cleaning kit. Now I'm taking paper towel and I'm wiping up that enzyme cleaner. So if you notice a urine smell or urine stains around your toilet, you really need to use an enzyme cleaner. That is what's going to get rid of that odor. Okay, now we're gonna deal with the bowl. And you'll see my technique here. I take the brush and I start by going right underneath the rim. Now this is important because remember I was telling you about those jets? You can get a lot of buildup, whether it's hard water or bacteria. And you wanna make sure you're scrubbing it. So once you've done a complete run around the rim, you can then start swirling your way down through the toilet bowl. Now, if you have stains that you can't get rid of, get a pumice stone, that's what it looks like, specifically for your toilet, and you can use that, just wet it a little bit, and rub out any of those difficult stains that you see in the toilet. Stick your toilet bowl brush down the chute a few times, give it a good twist, and flush your toilet, keeping the brush there to rinse it off. And then use the Clean My Space classic move of letting your toilet bowl brush drip dry underneath the lid. Cleaning a toilet is one of those jobs that so many of us cringe at, but truthfully, once you have the right products, tools, and techniques, including a really good pair of rubber gloves, it's far less intimidating. You know what you're doing, you can get the job done quickly and well, and you can actually feel proud and sit on that porcelain throne and do your business. Just feel good about yourself. And that brings me to this week's comment question, which is, what is your most memorable toilet experience, whether it was amazing or horrendous? I'm gonna tell you my amazing one, because I don't wanna put my horrendous one up for the public to hear about. But the amazing one, I was probably 20 years old and I was traveling in Europe and I went to a McDonald's, it was in Germany. I had to pay maybe a euro to use the bathroom. But every time somebody went in to use the bathroom, there was a bathroom attendant who went and like cleaned it up, and you felt like a rock star at McDonald's. You just went in, you did your business, You obviously weren't going to be horrible because you knew someone was coming in to clean it up right after you, but you could just sit down in peace and feel good and clean, and it was amazing. So I'd love to know what yours is in the comments down below. If you want to see what we're up to throughout the rest of the week, aside from filming Clean My Space videos, whether it's Riley stuff or Dream Home Reno stuff or other stuff, ideally that doesn't take place in a toilet, you can follow us on Instagram. I'm at Melissa Maker. Chad is at the Chad Reynolds, and the two of us are at Clean My Space. Here are a couple of other videos I think you're going to love. And if you want to learn more about our Makers Clean microfiber cloths, you can click that button right over there. There is a button down there that lets me know you care. So click it if you liked this video and click this button right here to subscribe and begin your journey to a cleaner life. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Now, for your performance task, you are tasked to document yourself through a video in cleaning your household toilet and bathroom. This task comprises of 50 points for the criteria: use of tools, materials, and equipment, 10 points, use of personal protective equipment, 10 points, cleaning processes, 10 points, workmanship, 10 points, timeliness, 10 points. Now, prepare your tools, materials, and equipment in cleaning your household, bathroom, and toilet. Oops! But before that, please do remember to wear personal protective equipment. This would include apron and gloves. Say goodbye to messy and dirty house. Bye-bye! Why there is a need to clean? Well, there are important reasons to keep your house clean, and there are surprising benefits of cleaning. Cleaning supports a strong immune system. Cleaning reduces stress. Cleaning can improve heart health. A clean bedroom will help you get a good night's sleep. A clean space helps increase your productivity. Cleaning can improve your mood and make you feel accomplished. Cleaning encourages a healthier lifestyle. What are you waiting for? Start cleaning. See you again next time.